This is ABC7 News at 7, your Suncoast News. We're here for you.
The thing about Steve Bannon that people don't understand is that in this campaign, he's been the general, and he's worked very closely with Reince Priebus and the rest of us as part of that small core team. We couldn't have done it without Priebus or Bannon.
Was hired as campaign chairman for Donald Trump back in August, and now the election is won, and Trump is keeping Steve Bannon close. Bannon will serve as chief strategist and senior advisor, but who is he? And how is he tied to us here on the Suncoast? Good evening, everyone. I'm Alan Cohen, and welcome to ABC 7 at 7. We'll have more on Stephen Bannon coming up, but first, our top 7 stories at 7. And we begin tonight with a milestone in the battle against human trafficking here on the Suncoast. A Sarasota County judge is sending a tough message with the first sentencing of a sex trafficker. Ronald McBride will spend the next 50 years in prison. McBride was convicted on 5 felony charges, ranging from robbery with a firearm to kidnapping. A key witness in the trial was one of the women McBride forced into prostitution. She testified McBride made her have sex with at least 10 men each day.
By this conviction and this sentence, one courageous woman is free from those invisible chains of human trafficking. And here in Sarasota County, we will not tolerate trafficking.
The case was a partnership between Sarasota Police, the state's attorney's office, and Sela Freedom. Authorities hope the sentencing will serve as a deterrent to other potential offenders. There are growing concerns tonight about the issue of untraceable guns across Florida. A Central Florida company is now offering kits so gun owners can build their own semi-automatic rifles without having to undergo a background check. They're called ghost guns without a serial number, meaning there's no way to trace them. Local gun shops warn people obtaining these weapons typically have sinister motives.
That's for the real enthusiast that wants to build the gun himself. He'll buy an 80 percenter, do the other 20% machining and milling, and then he's supposed to put a serial number to it for his own log. Now, if he doesn't do that, then that's a gun that shouldn't be on the street.
Local law enforcement agencies say they are not aware of the problem and have not seen any ghost guns here on the Suncoast yet. Right now, Sarasota County officials are meeting with the public over plans for a proposed I-75 overpass. It would be directly connect the future Lakewood Ranch Boulevard with Cattleman Road just south of University Parkway. The county says it will help relieve traffic jams and congestion on both University Parkway and Fruitville Road. A public workshop continues until 8 o'clock tonight at the Church of Hope on Wendell Kent Road. We'll have full details coming up at 11. Just up the road off of I-75, a popular restaurant and RV campground is under new ownership. An Australian real estate group named Riverloft is purchasing the Linger Lodge, the price tag just under $5 million. The Linger Lodge is best known for its bizarre menu items such as frog's legs and gator nuggets. Now to Manatee County, where there are new concerns over more than 500 gallons of wastewater at the Piney Point phosphate site. Opened in the 1960s, the plant has had a number of environmental issues. 5 years ago, there was a leak that threatened the area with contaminated water. Manatee County Parks and Natural Resources Director says there are no closure plans in place for the facility. There could be more issues in the future.
Well, we have a major U.S. Highway 41 that passes right next to this stack, and if there were an emergency release of any kind from the water stored atop of it, there would be problems for that roadway and people traveling along that roadway.
Hunsicker also says Piney Point poses a constant hazard to Lower Tampa Bay water levels as well. Sarasota Memorial Hospital is planning a major expansion to offer comprehensive cancer treatment in a single location. The Sarasota County Public Hospital Board approved the plan in October. $4 million has been set aside for the design phase, which is now underway. The cancer center will be built on the hospital's main campus, and it will offer services ranging from prevention to diagnosis and treatment to follow-up care. The hospital anticipates it will take 3 to 4 years to complete. Time is running out for those impacted by Hurricane Hermine to get financial assistance from the federal government. Storm victims have 13 more days to register for federal disaster assistance. Those who have been underinsured or uninsured for damage losses from the hurricane and live in the counties affected by the storm can apply. Manatee County is among the affected areas. The deadline to apply is Monday, November 28th. And Bob, we're almost out of hurricane season, but that is a reminder about how serious it could be.
Yeah, almost out is right. November 30th, the official end. However, there is an 80% chance we may have another system developing within the next 5 days. Its name would be Otto. We'll talk more about that a little later. But right now, beautiful evening as a result of a cold front that has slid on by. Right now, clear skies, 67 degrees. A dew point is comfortable and winds out of the north at 5. The pressure rising at 29.94 inches. High pressure building in behind the front. You can see the cloud cover slowly sinking to the south and east as the front has made its way through our area. Still a little bit of cloudiness around out there in the Gulf, but not much. And we are not anticipating any kind of rain threat at all overnight. The hourly forecast does call for lows to drop down into the upper 50s by around 5 a.m. Some areas getting into the mid 50s, and then we'll warm up into the mid 70s to upper 70s in the afternoon throughout the day on Wednesday. It will be a bit breezy to start things off, so it may be a little bit of a jacket or sweater morning for us to start the day off on Wednesday. Radar picture showing some pretty heavy rainfall just off the coast of Miami now, a few showers south of Marco Island, and not much going on here. All is quiet. As I mentioned, everything will stay that way too. And as far as the dry air is concerned, you see that dry air punching into the Gulf of Mexico all the way through north central Florida right now. And with that in place, its skies will be rather fair. And this is it. Season not over yet. Otto, maybe the 15th named storm of the season. In the next 5 days, the Hurricane Center is now suggesting an 80% chance developing. We'll let you know what some of the models are suggesting with this, but just shows you this has been a very long season. The first storm actually started in January of this year. It's amazing.
Stay away.
That's right. Looks like it will.
Thanks a lot, Bob. And still to come, Steve Bannon, you have probably been hearing that name a lot the last couple of days, but who is he? He has been appointed as chief strategist to President-elect Trump. We'll look into why many are already calling on Trump to get rid of him.
The official Suncoast Storm Team at ABC7. We're here for you.
Hi, I'm Joan London. And if you're worried about your parent or a loved one living alone like I was, and you want reliable senior care information, then call A Place for Mom, the nation's largest senior living referral service. You'll get free information on assisted living, Alzheimer's care, nursing homes, even important financial information.
They had obviously researched every place, not just given me names.
Really?
They found me a place for what she could afford, and it was magnificent.
We're now very confident that she's safe, and they just helped every step of the way, and I can't thank them enough.
So if you're struggling to find reliable senior living information, call A Place for Mom. This is a free service, and you can trust them to help you.
Call right now to get your free Senior Care Compass ebook. Find out about the 5 best kept secrets on financing senior care and assisted living.
Call now, 800-290-0352, 800-290-0352.
Come meet the artists and enjoy their creations at the Sarasota Fine Art Festival. Over 100 artists and thousands of works of contemporary art in photography, glass, sculpture, jewelry, and much more. The 4th Annual Sarasota Fine Art Festival, Saturday and Sunday, November 19th and 20th at Selby Five Points Park in downtown Sarasota. Bring your love and appreciation of art to the Sarasota Fine Art Festival. For more information, visit ParagonArtEvents.com.
On horrendously cold nights, on days when the rain has been relentless, or when the sun is beating down, there is an animal trapped with no protection, fighting to stay alive. Time is running out for them, but you can help save them by joining the ASPCA today. With your donation of just $18 a month, you'll help rescue abused and neglected animals, provide them with food, shelter, and medical care. When you go online or call in the next 10 minutes, we'll send you this free membership kit and our limited edition 150th anniversary t-shirt. It's just 60 cents a day to pull animals out of a terrible life. Don't let them suffer another day. Please help now.
Less than the week after winning the White House, President-elect Donald Trump continues to flesh out his White House team, but it's not coming without controversy. CNN's Tom Foreman explains.
For those who are concerned about this new administration, two names worry them a great deal, Breitbart and Bannon.
Behave yourself! Behave yourself! You are freaks and animals! You're freaks and animals!
From the beginning, Breitbart has been all about confronting liberals, the media, activists, the political establishment, anyone believed to be shouting down or shutting down conservative voices.
Do you even know what you're protesting? How much are you getting paid?
That's the late Andrew Breitbart, a blogger brought up in the Jewish faith who built the hugely influential right-wing media empire before his unexpected death in 2012. And these are the kind of headlines Breitbart churns out these days. Birth control makes women unattractive and crazy. Gay rights have made us dumber. The site called a conservative columnist a renegade Jew and asked, would you rather your child had feminism or cancer? At the helm for Breitbart News until recently, Steve Bannon.
We need to have a fight in the Republican Party for the soul of the conservative movement.
I agree with you.
He's a former Navy officer, former investment banker, according to Bloomberg, the most dangerous political operative in America, and now advisor to the president.
Look, the media is the Praetorian Guard of the permanent political class. All the consultants that come after you, the permanent political class's consultants, they're all in bed together.
So how did he get there? Early investment in the Seinfeld TV series led Bannon to a wealth of cash and experience in media, which he transformed into political battering rams.
She was sitting at the desk as
producing films to promote the political right, uncovering Anthony Weiner's sexting habit, exploiting the birther controversy around President Obama, bedeviling Democratic contender Hillary Clinton.
You have to understand how the Clintons, who proclaim that they support all your values, essentially have sold you out for money.
But Bannon's aggressive use of the Breitbart brand is under renewed scrutiny. Civil rights groups point to those incendiary headlines as evidence Bannon is pushing a white supremacist extreme right-wing agenda, while his allies brush the complaints aside.
And they now want to come back and say that anything anybody ever published in Breitbart is Steve Bannon. That's baloney.
With his role in the White House only loosely defined, it's hard to guess at his impact, but this is undeniably a heady time for Bannon. After years of sniping at the government from the outside, he is now as inside as anyone can be. Tom Foreman, CNN, Washington.
When we return, we'll have more on the controversial Bannon pick with our roundtable, plus we'll explain Bannon's direct connection to the Suncoast during the election.
I'm calling in regards about my mother, and I'm here, and I just want to thank you because it saved my mother's life yesterday. And I'd like to know the names of the people that came in and saved her so I could call and thank them. And she's doing fine. It's a wonderful thing. Thank you.
When you fall and cannot get up, an accident can turn into a tragedy. But with Life Alert, one touch of a button can get you help fast. Life Alert saves a person from a catastrophe every 10 minutes.
Life Alert is a lifesaver. If it weren't for Life Alert, I wouldn't be sitting here today.
For a free Life Alert brochure, call 1-800-652-3012. That's 1-800-652-3012. Call now 1-800-652-3012. For a free brochure, call 1-800-652-3012.
Whether you're a homeowner looking for a professional installation or a contractor looking for top quality products, Sarasota Glass and Mirror can meet your every need.
For 42 years, Sarasota Glass and Mirror has been the area's premier supplier and installer of quality glass products for your home or business. As an authorized PGT WindGuard dealer, we know how to protect your home with everything from the PGT WindGuard impact-resistant windows and doors to shower enclosures and decorative mirrors. The Sarasota Glass and Mirror team has the knowledge to tackle any project.
I knew I could get myself out of this. I just needed some hope.
and some help.
I took the first step to recovery when I made the call.
If you're depressed, drinking, and using drugs, you may need help. And the Affordable Care Act guarantees coverage of substance abuse. Call the Addiction, Hope, and Helpline now for a free assessment.
I had problems just getting to sleep, drinking, and using pills every night.
I feel like I'm losing control. I'm afraid I'll lose my job or even my family.
Are you losing hope? You can recover and get back on track. Call now for hope and help with proven gentle recovery programs.
I never thought that I could be somebody who didn't drink and use drugs.
I have something to hold on to for strength. I'm in recovery, getting the help I need.
Call the Addiction, Hope, and Helpline now for a free assessment with someone who cares.
Call 1-800-764-8708. That's 1-800-764-8708.
Welcome back. On Sunday, President-elect Trump made Stephen Bannon his chief strategist and senior counselor. The Bannon hire instantly drew criticism from hate watch groups who have noted Bannon's embrace of the alt-right movement made up of conservatives, populists, white supremacists, and anti-Semites. The Southern Poverty Law Center saying Trump should rescind this hire. The Anti-Defamation League voicing its opposition to Bannon because, quote, he and his alt-right are so hostile to the core American values, and House Democratic leader Nancy Pelosi saying there must be no sugarcoating the reality that a white nationalist has been named chief strategist for the Trump administration. And joining us for more on the appointment of Steve Bannon is Susan Nylon, a board member with the American Civil Liberties Union of Florida, Christian Ziegler, a state committee man for the Republican Party of Florida. You work with the ACLU, right?
I do. But I'm not really here tonight for the ACLU because I didn't. But
we want to make that clear.
Yeah.
Christian, I know you could not give a hoot when Nancy Pelosi says.
No, I mean, this is obviously expected.
But when it comes to issues involving racism, white supremacy, the Anti-Defamation League and the Southern Poverty Law Center is... they pretty much are the most credible organizations in the United States talking about those issues, and they flat out consider
those are liberal organizations. For years, they defended liberals and they promoted liberals.
Defamation League.
But when you look at Steve Bannon, you start talking about his comments, and they call him anti-Semite and stuff. I mean, let's not forget, like, he headed up Breitbart. Breitbart was actually Jewish himself, right? Andrew Breitbart. The first seven hires to Breitbart News were actually Jewish. They have plenty of Jewish people that work for them that are actually big-time contributors that work under Steve Bannon, that is Steve Bannon's hired. So this is just an effort by the liberals. I'll tell you, they lost a big election last week, and they need to turn the corner, and they need to redirect blame, and they need to change the subject. And that's what you're seeing with Nancy Pelosi and all the Democrats doing right now.
Christian, I got to tell you, you cannot stay with that argument. First of all, civil liberties are not a liberal issue. They're an American issue. So everything that they're talking about right now has nothing to do with whether they're liberal or not. If you are anti-Semite, it's not like the liberals are only sensitive to that issue.
But where's the proof? Where's the proof that he's anti-Semite? What is the proof?
His words that he uses, what he refers to people as on tape, on radio interviews, on television interviews, it's all there. Things that he's written. On top of it, things that he's allowed to go on in his own publication.
Glenn Beck is no liberal.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, he's probably one of the most popular broadcasters.
He's been an anti-Trump guy for a long time.
To many people watching this broadcast tonight, mm-hmm. to Republicans who live on the Sun Coast, he is wildly popular. He said, when people come to understand that the alt-right, this neo-nationalist, neo-Nazi, white supremacy idea that Bannon is pushing hard, I hope they wake up, because if not, we are racist.
Yeah, but look at this. Okay, so Glenn Beck has been attacking Donald Trump for countless number of months
now. But he's not a liberal.
He's not a liberal, but he's an anti-Trump guy. So you have the liberals, you have the never-Trumpers that are going after Trump because they're sore losers. Look, Donald Trump, he won the electoral vote. If you look at the votes, he's won over 300 votes, and it's a shame that everyone's trying to tear up, you know, Steve Bannon and try to focus on this when the real issue should be Donald Trump won, time to move forward, and it's time to make this country great again. That's what we're going to do.
Steve, I got to say, Bannon has always been a controversial figure long before he teamed up with Donald Trump. So it's not because of it's a reaction from the election itself. It's a reaction that if this is a man who's supposed to unify the country, and what does he do? Not only does he pick a man that's so polarizing, even actually more polarizing than Donald Trump himself,
Before we go any further, let's tell folks why we are talking about Stephen Bannon.
Yeah.
Okay,
that's
sure.
Because he's registered to vote here.
Yeah.
How did that happen?
He is, and he doesn't live here either.
Well, no, he was registered to vote here. He's registered in New York now. But the way it works, just I've actually been in the same similar situation. When you are a political guy that goes up D.C. and you work, you don't usually switch your address directly up there because you're there temporarily. So you have to find a place to register to vote. You buy property. You keep all your stuff somewhere. I don't know about his specific connections to Sarasota. I know he was registered in Miami, then he was registered here, then he was registered in New York, where he's actually been spending a lot of time. So I read an article today. He voted in New York, which is where he's been spending the last couple months anyway. I don't know. I mean, that's an issue you probably have to talk to Steve
but
about.
But it's kind of ironic, since it was the Trump campaign that talked about election irregularities and voting.
Well,
and
there's nothing, but there's nothing illegal about what he's done. I mean, I think people have looked at it, and if there was anything illegal, obviously they would have gone after him. I mean, you have obviously Barack Obama, the head of the government, with his, you know, Department of Justice, and they would have stepped in if there was something illegal. There's nothing illegal. People are just talking about, well, what's the coincidence that his voter registration in Sarasota? Again, nothing illegal, everything by the book. And if there was a problem, obviously it would have been exposed by now.
Last word, Susan.
Well, I just think it's kind of ironic that the same people who were screaming about election rigging and all these misgivings about the election don't mention it at all right now.
That's not apples to apples, because that's we're having issues with people illegally voting. He's not illegally voting.
No, you're correct. But he did leave a question.
Why don't we take a pause right now? Our discussion of Steve Bannon and Trump's appointment is just getting started. But when we return, we'll bring you a check on the evening forecast.
Tomorrow at 5 on ABC7, your Suncoast News.
Marijuana could be bad for people's hearts. Details in Health Smart.
Tomorrow at 5 on ABC7, your Suncoast News. We're here for you.
Christmas Traditions by LuxArts Silks, where more is merrier. Make your holidays sparkle with style. Browse our amazing showroom, cute collectible cottages, and beautiful Christmas displays. Find the inspiration, selection, and quality you need to deck the halls merry and bright. Christmas Traditions also features the area's largest selection of quality pre-lit Christmas trees. Every size, shape, and color, and plenty of decorations to make your home shine for the holidays. Christmas Traditions by LuxArts Silks, where more is merrier. Visit us on New 301, just a quarter mile north of University Parkway.
Is your mop a dirty, disgusting mess? You need the Hurricane 360 Spin Mop System, the only mop and bucket that spins the dirt away. A system that cleans practically anything and everything with super absorbent microfiber. Dip it in the washer side and the mess releases into the bucket. Then place it in the dryer side and push on the pedal. You get a clean mop head that's practically dry and ready for more. And your hands will never again touch a dirty, disgusting mop. The heads are washable and reusable. Get the Hurricane 360 Spin Mop System for just two payments of $19.99. You'll also get a Sticky Buddy, the reusable sticky roller that picks up pet hair and lint and washes clean in seconds. You can take advantage of our 2-for-1 pick it up special and get a second spin mop set. Just pay additional shipping and fee. And we'll upgrade you to free priority handling. So don't wait. Order now.
Call 1-800-394-1524 to get your Hurricane Spin Mop double offer. So hurry and call 1-800-394-1524. Call now.
For your plumbing, electrical, or air conditioning, and services is qualified, and service calls are free, and services.com, andservices.com.
If you have a suspicion for harboring prostate cancer, we have a way of diagnosing by using an exquisite instrument called 3-dimensional color flow power Doppler ultrasound. Using this system, we can identify abnormalities within the prostate that you could otherwise never detect. The Dottoli Cancer Center is the only center in the southeastern United States which has this technology. If you have prostate cancer, we will find it.
We'll have more of our roundtable and the appointment of Steve Bannon coming up, but right now let's get a check on our weather forecast from ABC7 Chief Meteorologist Bob Harrigan.
Thanks, Alan. A beautiful day today. It was mainly in the afternoon as the front made its way through. Skies cleared up. We had some clouds around earlier today. Temperatures were slightly below average. Finally, most of it's been above average all fall long, and a beautiful sunset tonight. And currently we do have fair skies overhead. Some photos sent in. This is a Nice eagle shot there. And then it's at the Celery Fields in Sarasota, just east of I-75. Appreciate that nice shot there. Evening forecast calling for temperatures to drop down into the low 60s, already in the low 60s in inland areas. We are anticipating low temperatures, a bit chilly tomorrow morning, mid-50s in the inland areas, upper 50s right near the beaches. That front has moved on through. We have this north to northeasterly wind, and that is bringing in this cooler and drier air now, and that will stay with us right through the rest of this work week. And then get this, another reinforcing shot of cold air will move through late Saturday, and you'll notice a big difference on Sunday come this weekend. Currently, we have mostly fair skies, 67. The dew point's what's so nice, it's low at 52 degrees. Winds are out of the north at 5. The pressure on the rise, 29.94 inches. High pressure is building in from the Gulf of Mexico. There's the high today, 77 degrees. 79 is the average, and the record high, 88, set back in 1993. No rainfall officially in most areas, although at the airport, just 1/100th of an inch of rain so far for the month. That's all we've had there as a result of some dry air that's been in place for most of the southeast. 61 in Tallahassee, already down to 55 in Jacksonville. It's 64 in Orlando, still warm out ahead of the front in Key West, 73, 70 in Miami, and current temperatures around town already in the upper 50s in Avon Park, Sebring, Lake Placid. So they'll get down into the low 50s in this particular area. We'll be into the mid 50s to upper 50s right near the coast. 67 now in Sarasota, 68 in Cortez, Bradenton, you're at 66 degrees. Same in Palmetto and 67 degrees in Southgate, Siesta Key, a degree warmer. Northport at 65 and Inglewood at 67 degrees. Currently, we are looking at mostly fair skies overnight. Tomorrow, we'll start off with sunshine. There'll be plenty of it. Temperatures warming right about average, 78 degrees. Really hardly any clouds in the sky. That's a result of this dry air. You can see it on our scale here, continuing to punch in from the west, and it is thick all throughout the Gulf of Mexico. So we are not anticipating any kind of cloud formation there. We're keeping an eye on this formation right here. This could be our next storm, the 15th named storm of the season. Otto may be developing in the western Caribbean. In fact, a lot of reliable forecast models are suggesting it's almost there, and 80% chance of it developing over the next 5 days. If it were to develop, more than likely it wouldn't do much. It would stay down there as a result of a high-pressure ridge to the north and just kind of caught up in a very light steering flow. And the chances of it developing, 80% next 5 days. And it looks as though if it were to develop, again, I said it would stay more than likely in this same location over the next 5 days, not doing much, eventually shifting off to the east as it gets picked up by a cold front. Well, statewide temperatures across the United States, 55 in Boston, Detroit, 49, 60 in Denver, Salt Lake City at 58. So a little bit warmer out in the western United States, Dallas now at 74 degrees. For boaters, starts off a bit breezy, subsiding somewhat in the afternoon. Seas running 2 to 3 feet with a moderate chop out there. We just had a low tide. We'll have a high tide 11:56, another low tide 11:25. Tonight, turning cooler, 55 for your low, mostly fair. It will be a little bit chilly to wake things up tomorrow. North winds 5 to 10. And then tomorrow, beautiful day, 78, north winds 5 to 10. You don't get much better than that. The extended forecast does call for delightful weather through Saturday. And then get your sweaters and jackets out on Sunday, Monday. Look for low temperatures Monday morning, upper 40s to low 50s. Alan will be right back after this.
Hi, I'm Joan London, and if you're worried about your parent or a loved one living alone like I was, and you want reliable senior care information, then call A Place for Mom, the nation's largest senior living referral service. You'll get free information on assisted living, Alzheimer's care, nursing homes, even important financial information.
They had obviously researched every place, not just given me names. Really? They found me a place for what she could afford, and it was magnificent.
We're now very confident that she's safe, and they just helped every step of the way, and I can't thank them enough.
So if you're struggling to find reliable senior living information, call A Place for Mom. This is a free service, and you can trust them to help you.
Call right now to get your free Senior Care Compass ebook. Find out about the 5 best kept secrets on financing senior care and assisted living.
Call now, 800-290-0352. 800-290-0352.
You only have one life. Are you gambling with it? 1 in 3 adults have high blood pressure. Not knowing your numbers could cause you to lose big time. Luckily, you can turn the odds in your favor by getting your blood pressure checked today. Don't leave your health to chance. Learn more at heart.org/HPB.
an important message for Americans eligible for Medicare.
Are you receiving all the benefits available to you? Do you know there is money available to lower your Medicare prescription costs?
Now's the time to find the coverage that's right for you at the right price. The way to do that is to explore your options. You can spend hours doing that yourself, or you can call Health Markets and let us do the legwork for you with no cost or obligation. We'll search a variety of plans from nationally recognized companies to find the coverage that's the best fit for you at a price that fits your budget, and we'll do it at no charge to you.
Plus, you may be able to save money on prescriptions. We'll tell you if you qualify.
Why pay a penny more than you have to for an insurance policy?
Let us find you the right plan at the right price and see if you qualify to lower your prescription costs.
Put our free service to work for you at no charge.
Call the number on the screen now to make sure you're getting all the benefits you deserve. Don't wait. Call now.
Welcome back. If you're just joining us, it has been a week since the election, and we're already learning some of President-elect Donald Trump's picks for the top jobs. One of those picks is raising some controversy. Steve Bannon joining us for more on the new White House chief strategist is media specialist Susan Nylon, who serves as CEO of Nylon and Associates, and Christian Ziegler, state committee man for the Republican Party of Florida. I want to talk about other issues with the transition, but let's stay on Steve Bannon for a little bit, because I don't remember this kind of controversy about an appointment to a new administration that does not have to be confirmed by the Senate. Do either one of you recall anything like this?
I actually do. Okay. In the beginning, in 2009, and now I'm drawing a blank for his name, he was head of the Green Energy, and he's now on CNN. I forgot his name.
Van Jones.
Yep. If you remember, there was a lot of controversy over him because of something he did when he was 20. But that doesn't compare to what we're talking about here with Bannon, and I think that makes a big difference. However, the difference was Van Jones stepped down right away because he didn't want to be a blight on the administration. So I don't see Steve Bannon doing that.
Alan, Steve Bannon has been on Team Trump for like 6 months now.
Yeah.
And now the issue's coming up. So I think what people
the
questions were raised.
Because he has an appointment.
Well, but questions were raised about Steve Bannon at the time. And then the American public actually came out and voted, knowing that Steve Bannon was on Donald Trump's team and Donald Trump won. So I think the real question is right now is why is this coming up? And I'll tell you why it's coming up. Is you have liberals, you have people that oppose Donald Trump on both sides that are sore losers. And now after the election, what they're doing is they're coming out. Let me just finish.
Okay.
They're coming out, and what they're going to do is this is a typical tactic of the left, is when they lose at the ballot box, they try to rip people down. And now they're focused on attacking Steve Bannon as an individual to really change the narrative from Democrats totally failed and lost this election that everyone thought they were going to win.
But so. Let me just ask you this. And again, it's not just Democrats or liberals who are raising this issue.
But it's people that oppose Trump.
Here's the question. Breitbart,
yeah.
Alt-right, accusations that it gives credence to white supremacy. Mayo Yiannopoulos, I can't pronounce his name, but you've probably seen him on TV. Mm-hmm. He wrote in March that the alt-right uses anti-Semitic imagery, but only to shock older generations. I mean, you've heard these allegations before about the alt-right and Breitbart.
Well, they also accuse the alt-right of being against homosexuals, and actually Milo is a homosexual.
Yeah.
And so I think that people are picking words and taking them out of context to fit a narrative that the media is trying to generate after this election to tear Steve Bannon down once he's in. So I think that's what we're seeing, and they're having success because they're dominating the headlines. But I think what we need to be talking about is the fact that Americans knew about this before they voted for Donald Trump. They selected Donald Trump. Steve Bannon was on Donald Trump's team, and now it's time to move forward and piece this country together.
You need to not just lump Americans into selecting Donald Trump or the team or anything else, because it's not true. He won by the Electoral College. He didn't win by the majority vote. So there's a lot of people out there that are very angry right now. And that being said, like I said a little earlier, if this is supposed to be a move to unify, why would you pick such a polarizing individual, let alone give him equal power to the chief of staff?
Two things. Number one, the Electoral College, that's how you elect a president. No one talks about the Carolina Panthers winning 15 games last season and having the best record because the Denver Broncos actually won the Super Bowl.
But the Electoral College doesn't knock on your door saying we're really
But the Electoral College, he won overwhelmingly. I mean, 306 votes now. from the Electoral College that he actually had. He is the president, and it's not about unifying the country right now. I mean, that's part of it, but it's also about putting people in place to fix this country and fix the problems. Right. And Steve Bannon has taken the lead against corruption.
But he doesn't have the skill to do it.
Well, I mean, whether he has the skill or not, that would be on Donald Trump. The question, Susan, is shouldn't any president be allowed to pick the people that they choose to, to advise
absolutely.
The council?
And we've never denied him that, but that doesn't mean he's beyond reproach with his choices. It doesn't mean that he isn't up for scrutiny over his choices. And, you know, there was a lot to question. And I get the Electoral College, and that's fine. But those aren't the people who are going to be knocking on the door and expecting service. And when you put someone in who's just like him, what message does that send to the rest of the world?
Okay. Enough of Steve Bannon. Let's talk about the rest of the transition. There are already some bumps in the road. Chris Christie has been shoved aside a little bit. Mike Pence is now in charge of the transition, the incoming vice president. Is it unusual for transitions in terms of when the new administration is coming in from the other party to have this kind of bump in the road? Because they both parties had transition teams in anticipation of winning.
Sure.
So they've been at this for months.
Well, yeah, but when you look at this, I mean, you have Mike Pence, who's a proven guy in Washington. He knows how Washington works. He's been there. He has a lot of relationships on the Hill. Obviously, he was busy campaigning before the election. I'm not too shocked that the pre-election transition team has now shifted to a post-election transition team. And I think that's what we've seen. And I think no one better on the Trump team than Mike Pence to head up that effort. So I'm actually excited about it.
Susan?
Yeah, I mean, I think really the issue is Chris Christie has a lot of other problems that he needs to deal with in his home state. And so he was not the candidate anyway. The fact that he was actually the leader of the transition team to begin with was a little surprising. But it's not unusual. I've seen it before that they always go through a little bit of, you know, working things through.
Let's talk about some other names. Rudy Giuliani, possible Secretary of State. Good pick.
Yeah, I'd love to see him at Justice Department, too, as Attorney General. But I think whatever Rudy does, I mean, America loves him, and I think the world would respect him.
They also threw John Bolton's name in there as well for Secretary of State, and I was pretty surprised about that, too.
Well, John Bolton, and I don't know if he's been eliminated from that position, but he's known as a neoconservative who does not exactly have the same kind of outlook on foreign policy as Donald Trump does. So, figure that out for me.
Yeah, well, I mean, we'll see if he ends up getting picked. But I think Bolton is, you know, what he and Trump have in common is they're a very America first kind of individual that they're going to be focused on America's interests.
Let's say it's Rudy Giuliani, Susan. What kind of foreign policy does that mean for the United States?
I have absolutely no idea because I don't know what he stands for as far as foreign policy. I mean, he's always identified with New York and he doesn't really go beyond that. So I've got no clue.
Trump's still going to lead. I mean, his leadership and his views on foreign policy, that's what's going to drive this discussion. And, you know, again, it's about having a strong America and preventing us getting in all these wars around the world by having a strong and respected military and a strong and respected country.
Is there an issue inside the transition of those members of the Republican establishment who might be ideal candidates for some of these positions but did not support his presidential campaign? And possibly turning to people who have been with him all along. How do you look at that?
That'll be an interesting dynamic because obviously Trump ran against the establishment and ran against Washington, and there's a lot of people in Washington that, you know, maybe he's going to need their help. But, I mean, you look, he brought the chairman of the RNC over, Chairman Priebus, who is very connected to a lot of the establishment players in Washington. So I think Trump's kind of opened up his mind and he's been willing to kind of reach out and put a hand across to the establishment and bring in a couple of them. But at the end of the day, Trump's coming in, and I heard that he's going to split time between Washington, New York, and Florida, and I think that makes a lot of sense because it's good to get out of that beltway.
I don't think he's bringing the establishment in. I think he's always been a part of the establishment. He's been well known for spending time and writing checks and calling on them. So this anti-establishment movement was very short-minded because not only did he bring in a lot of the establishment, they sent the establishment back to their seats to begin with.
One interesting dynamic, going back to Steve Bannon for a moment, is, you know, Reince Priebus, incoming chief of staff, very close friends with Paul Ryan, Steve Bannon, not so much. I mean, Breitbart
That's
has done a pretty good job over the last couple of months in basically making Paul Ryan into almost being one of the enemies.
Well, I think Steve Bannon spent his career going after the establishment and going after
Beltway
politics.
So how does he deal with Congress?
But I think when you look at that, you have Mike Pence as vice president. I think Pence is hopefully going to lead the effort towards Congress. But even with Bannon, I know he's been reaching out the past 2 days. He's been calling down to all the congressmen and starting to develop that rapport. But, you know, kudos to Donald Trump for bringing two different individuals with two different ideologies to the table so he can expand his view.
Susan, you get the last word.
I think it's going to be a very interesting watch, at least over the next year, to see what happens. I'm not as optimistic as Christian is. I think there's going to be a lot of problems between both Steve Bannon and Reince Priebus because they rule differently, and because they have equal power, it's going to be a problem.
All right, we have to take a break, but when we return, we'll have final thoughts from our guests. Plus, we'll hear from some of our viewers saying about a food safety issue in Sarasota at an elementary school yesterday.
Hurricane season is here. Are you prepared? ABC7 has the information you need. Access our special Surviving a Hurricane Now. Learn how to prepare a readiness plan and survival kit. Know your evacuation route. Be prepared, Suncoast, when severe weather threatens. Access our special on our ABC7 app and all our live streaming platforms.
Apple TV, Amazon Fire TV, and Roku.
They care. They take the time to understand you, take the time to understand your case.
There's no better satisfaction to me than to see a client who is happy because of the job we've done for them.
It's really actually very comforting to know that there's someone that you've heard of and you're getting recommendations about that you can turn to when you have a problem.
I felt like I had a partner in this, and he was going to be by my side.
On horrendously cold nights, on days when the rain has been relentless, or when the sun is beating down, there is an animal trapped with no protection, fighting to stay alive. Time is running out for them, but you can help save them by joining the ASPCA today. With your donation of just $18 a month, you'll help rescue abused and neglected animals, provide them with food, shelter, and medical care. When you go online or call in the next 10 minutes, we'll send you this free membership kit and our limited edition 150th anniversary t-shirt. It's just 60 cents a day to pull animals out of a terrible life. Don't let them suffer another day. Please help now.
Is your old garage door stuck or broken? Would a new one give you a lift? Let Precision Door Overhead Garage Door Service of Sarasota come to the rescue with prompt and affordable repair service. Replacement doors come with an array of styles and colors, and they are rated to meet and exceed Florida standards. From estimates to installation, your satisfaction is our priority. If you're not 100% satisfied with any product, service, or installation, we will make it right, because Precision Door Service is a name you can trust.
Welcome back. Over the next 2 months, we'll be learning more about who will fill Donald Trump's White House administration coming in January. Our guests join us now for final thoughts on some of the early selections. And, you've already promised to send the clip of tonight's show to Steve Bannon. So thanks a lot for that. Susan, is this just a controversy that's going to last a couple of days, or is this, do you believe, going to carry on for a while?
You know, I believe it's going to be fed by the people that are in the center of the controversy. I think that he's a very controversial individual, and he's always welcomed controversy. So I think his actions are going to keep it going. I don't think they're going to survive. I think one of the two are going to end up being gone, and most likely it's him.
What do you mean, one of the two?
Well, between him and Reince, it's unusual that a chief of staff has equal power to the, what is it, political strategist or whatever.
Worked pretty well in the Reagan administration.
Correct. Mm-hmm. So that's unusual. We're talking about two people that are accustomed to having power on top of helping another man who's accustomed to having power. So I think Bannon will probably just leave out of frustration, not because of a controversy.
Christian, whether you think it's fair or not, this is being discussed around the country, not just on television or in the newspapers, but you see stories of people saying, you know, linking Bannon and Breitbart to whether it's anti-Semitism, white supremacy, or anti-gay issues. This is not good for a new administration.
Look, Alan, again, this is something. Bannon's been on Team Trump for 6 months, and they brought it up a little bit and didn't have much traction because we were in the middle of a campaign.
Right.
Now they have a huge loss, and Nancy Pelosi and the Democrats have to save face. So what they're doing is they're pivoting, and they're trying to pull this up and make this the topic of conversation. I think that we have a lot of sore losers. So liberals are pretty upset, and the Democratic Party should be reflecting on where their failures were instead of trying to tear someone down and change the discussion. I'm an elector, and I will tell you, my inbox is full of emails from liberals telling me to change my electoral vote, which is actually against the law in Florida, to vote for Hillary Clinton. That's not happening. But again, sore losers. This is what we're dealing with.
Susan,
they're desperate.
They are desperate.
They're desperate out of fear of the changes that are going to come. And that's the concern. It's no longer about, oh yeah, we lost, because they're not talking about Hillary anymore. Mm-hmm. They're talking about preventing what is going to happen.
Okay, we'll have to leave it there. I want to thank both of you. But before we go, we want to share with you what some of our viewers are saying about a story that we told you about last night. Florida's Department of Health is investigating an incident at the Goshio Elementary School after mold was found in some breakfast items being served to students. Sarasota County serves 30,000 meals every day, and cafeteria staff follow procedures by throwing out the rest of the shipment and warning other schools. But here is what some of you are saying about the incident. Nicholas White writes, "Both my kids came home the same day vomiting from the same school. Makes complete sense now. How disgusting." Kimberly Herbeck writes, "This is not about making your kids lunch or not. This is about the fact that the school is serving spoiled food. Sarasota County is one of the richest, most expensive places to live in Florida, but it's okay to serve spoiled food to children." And Susan Smith writes, "If only parents would actually learn how to feed their own children. Wine, wine, wine." Susan, really? Really? If you'd like to join the conversation about tonight's topic, just visit our Facebook page at facebook.com/news at 7. And FYI, want to watch past roundtable discussions? They're available on Apple TV, Amazon Fire, and Roku. Thank you for our guests for being here tonight. Susan Nylon is a media specialist and CEO of Nylon Associates. And Christian Ziegler is a state committee man with the Republican Party of Florida and may know a school committee member. When we return, we'll speak with ABC7's business commentator Richard Stern about the way the markets have reacted to the Trump victory this past week. Plus, another government transition is taking place in Tallahassee. We'll tell you why there are so many new faces in the state legislature in our primetime headlines.
I owed the IRS $10,000.
I owed the IRS $20,000.
The IRS garnished my wages.
They put a lien on my house.
The IRS is the most powerful collection agency in the world. They do not give up until you pay.
I couldn't sleep. We were being audited. I called Tax Solutions Now, and a great big weight was lifted off my shoulders.
I called Tax Solutions Now, and they got the IRS off my back.
Tax Solutions Now had my wage garnishment lifted in 48 hours.
Tax Solutions Now can get you help. Our agents know the rules, can stop the pain, and get you the best deal.
We saved our home and overcame the most powerful collection agency in the world.
We connect you with a team of former IRS agents and tax professionals who get the IRS off your back.
Time is running out. Call Tax Solutions Now.
Call 1-800-565-7740. That's 1-800-565-7740.
Selling your home? Insist on a 3D showcase tour from Gulf Shores Realty. Virtual tours are flat and boring and look more like a slideshow than a tour. A 3D tour from Gulf Shores Realty is like actually walking through the home without the drive. Get instant access to your next home from any device. Multiple views give homebuyers a perspective like no other. For a limited time, mention ABC7 and Gulf Shores Realty will provide a complimentary 3D tour with your new listing.
Come meet the artists and enjoy their creations at the Sarasota Fine Art Festival. Over 100 artists and thousands of works of contemporary art in photography, glass, sculpture, jewelry, and much more. The 4th Annual Sarasota Fine Art Festival, Saturday and Sunday, November 19th and 20th at Selby Five Points Park in downtown Sarasota. Bring your love and appreciation of art to the Sarasota Fine Art Festival. For more information, visit ParagonArtEvents.com.
Welcome back. Few people could have predicted a Trump victory in the presidential election, and even fewer could have predicted how the market would surge in the wake of the nation's choice. Joining us for more on the past week as well on Wall Street is ABC7 business commentator Richard Stern. The market has gone up since the election a week ago, Richard. Is it still going up?
Believe it or not, Alan, it still is. This is truly extraordinary. I hate to go back over old numbers, but the bottom line is the Monday and Tuesday being election day, the Dow Jones Industrial Average was up by 443 points on the assumption that Hillary Clinton was going to win. Donald Trump wins, so what happens Thursday and Wednesday? The Dow Jones Industrial Average is up by 470 points. We have not had a down day since Monday, the day before Election Day. We've set four new record closes. We're only 77 points from 19,000 on the Dow, and the buying continues.
Now, Richard, we talked about this a couple of weeks ago, and at the time you told us the market was expecting Hillary Clinton to win and that the market would go up if that were to happen. But the reason why the market may have preferred Clinton over Trump is that Trump added an element of uncertainty that, and Wall Street doesn't like uncertainty, that it kind of goes along with everything in terms of polling, that we really don't know what happens when it gets down to that. Isn't that correct?
Alan, you're absolutely right. I don't know what to say except we were all wrong. The pollsters were wrong. Certainly the people who said that the market would literally collapse if Trump were elected, they've been proven wrong. I don't know quite what else to say, but you're absolutely right. One of the oldest statements on Wall Street is, just tell me what's going to happen. I don't want any surprises. We had one, and we had an even bigger surprise as to the reaction, and so far, it continues. I always remind my clients, you know, markets don't go one way forever, and one of these days we'll have not only a down day, but maybe even a correction. But right now, people are on, interest rates continue low. They will move higher, but the bottom line is people have to put their money to work, and the bond market doesn't seem the place to be.
Richard, we only have a couple of seconds left, but is there any indication about whether this will continue in terms of the market going up?
I think it's unrealistic to go up every single day. I think it's unrealistic to see, frankly, gains of 6% in a week and a half. There are years when we don't go up by 6%, Alan. So the bottom line is, no, this will not continue.
All right. Richard, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
And when we return, we will have more on Governor Rick Scott and what he will reach his term limits in 2018. But there are already rumors about where he will go when that time comes. The details in our primetime headlines.
I'm calling in regards about my mother, and I'm here, and I just want to thank you because it saved my mother's life yesterday. And I'd like to know the names of the people that came in and saved her so I could call and thank them. And she's doing fine. It's a wonderful thing. Thank you.
When you fall and cannot get up, an accident can turn into a tragedy. But with Life Alert, one touch of a button can get you help fast. Life Alert saves a person from a catastrophe every 10 minutes.
Life Alert is a lifesaver. If it weren't for Life Alert, I wouldn't be sitting here today.
For a free Life Alert brochure, call 1-800-652-3012. That's 1-800-652-3012. Call now, 1-800-652-3012. For a free brochure, call 1-800-652-3012.
Alex Karras Lincoln's holiday sales event is here. Drive a brand new 2017 Lincoln MKC Sports Utility for $269 per month or a 2017 MKZ for $299 per month. We are proud to introduce the newest addition to the Lincoln lineup, the all-new 2017 Lincoln Continental. We have a great selection and ready for immediate delivery. Alex Karras Lincoln, affordable luxury. Winner of the prestigious 2015 President's Award, serving Florida's Sun Coast since 1978. We're located 2 miles north of the Sarasota-Bradenton Airport on US 41.
Is your mop a dirty, disgusting mess? You need the Hurricane 360 Spin Mop System, the only mop and bucket that spins the dirt away. A system that cleans practically anything and everything with super absorbent microfiber. Dip it in the washer side and the mess releases into the bucket. Then place it in the dryer side and push on the pedal. You get a clean mop head that's practically dry and ready for more. And your hands will never again touch a dirty, disgusting mop. The heads are washable and reusable. Get the Hurricane 360 Spin Mop System for just two payments of $19.99. You'll also get a Sticky Buddy, the reusable sticky roller that picks up pet hair and lint and washes clean in seconds. You can take advantage of our 2-for-1 pick it up special and get a second spin mop set. Just pay additional shipping and fee. And we'll upgrade you to free priority handling. So don't wait. Order now.
Call 1-800-394-1524 to get your Hurricane Spin Mop double offer. So hurry and call 1-800-394-1524. Call now.
Now a look at your primetime headlines amid ongoing demonstrations protesting the election of Donald Trump nationwide. More and more people are also speaking out against the alleged hate crimes targeting minority groups since the election. More than 300 hate incidents have been reported so far, most against minority and religious groups. This comes as protests continue across the nation as students, some too young to vote, are walking out of class and joining the ongoing protests against President-elect Donald Trump.
It's just absurd and it's horrible. And that's why we're here tonight, to show that we're against it.
In these next 4 years, it really is up to us to kind of fight for the things that I think Donald Trump will change or will try to change.
Trump says he does not condone acts of violence and is urging perpetrators to stop. More than 60 newly elected lawmakers are making their way to the state capitol today. The 120-member House will have 46 new members, while half of the 40-member Senate is turning over. The change is due to, in part, term limits and redistricting. Senate President-designate Joe Negron says new legislators could mean fresh ideas in Tallahassee.
This process really relies on goodwill, on integrity, on keeping your word. That doesn't mean there can't be a robust difference of opinion on issues. In fact, there should be, and we welcome that.
Technically, the new members took office upon their election, but the House and Senate will hold an organizational session next Tuesday that will include formal swearing-in ceremonies. Governor Rick Scott has denied rumors he would play a role in the Trump administration, saying he plans to finish out his term as governor, but what happens in 2018? Scott is now considering a run for U.S. Senate, calling the move an option. Senator Bill Nelson currently holds the seat and will be up for grabs for in 2 years. Term limits prevent Scott from seeking another term as governor. Five states, including Florida, are getting nearly $370 million for 25 projects to restore natural resources damaged by the 2010 BP Deepwater Horizon spill. The National Fish and Wildlife Foundation says Louisiana and Alabama will get the most money, but Florida is set to receive $32 million. The Florida Fish and Wildlife Foundation will use $19 million on four critical conservation projects. FWC plans to continue conservation programs for shorebirds, fisheries, and sea turtle standing responses. The fourth project aids in the recovery of oyster reefs in the Big Bend region. And that's all the time we have for this evening. I'm Alan Cohn. Thanks for joining us. Have a good night.